Every time I walk out of my house is a form of activism.
For a long time, I had heard bisexuality talked about as kind of a joke or a punchline.
I unfortunately have been discriminated against because of my gender identity.
Our community and every aspect of our life is under attack.
Happiness is the best thing, being able to freely be yourself. And I was ready to lose friends or family. So I remember calling my mom, and I just started bawling. I just started crying. And she's like, oh my God, what's wrong? What's wrong? And I said, Mom, I said, I'm gay, and I don't want you to be disappointed in me. And she said, how can I be disappointed in something that I already knew?
It took about four or five years for me to really come to terms and understand that I wasn't a lesbian and I wasn't straight, that I was bisexual. Once I was able to really know myself, I was able to really defend myself and my community.
When I was a senior in high school at a Christian school in northern New Jersey, for our Bible class's final exam, we had to write a letter to a friend who had recently come out as gay. And what I struggled with was writing a 500-word letter to myself, telling me why what I thought, what I did, and who I thought I was wrong.
We like to pride ourselves on the fact that we have made significant progress as a community, but unfortunately, for transgender folks, there still is misunderstanding and stigma.
History shows that transgender women, especially trans women of color, they've led us, but I think we've also let them down in some ways.
I think my number one wish would just be that everyone can be who they are and love who they love just unapologetically.
And have that opportunity without facing discrimination, without facing hate.
And let people live, period.
Remember why we live in a democracy.
Speak up, show up.
Fight back.
Go out and vote. It makes such a difference.